Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Now, in yesterday's Netcast, we had a question from Leon, and Leon wanted to know how to extend a series. Basically, we had these set of numbers. He wanted to be able to have a formula that would forecast the next number in the series. And I showed how to use the forecast function, but in order to do that, I had to insert a brand new column with the numbers. Yesterday was 1 through 5. Today, we would need the numbers 1 through 7. Well, I want to talk about this function called the row function, equal row of A1. Will return the number 1. And of course, as I copy that down to the other rows, it gives me 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's just a great way, basically, to enter a quick series of numbers, 1 through 7. So what we can do is use that function in order to generate the numbers 1 through 7. So equal forecast. We want the 8th number now. These are the known y's from A1 down through A7. And the known x's just need to be the numbers from 1 through 7. Someone asked for the row of A1 through A7. Now, because that's going to return several numbers, that's going to return 7 numbers, we have to enter this as an array formula. That means holding down Control and Shift while hitting Enter, and Excel will figure out exactly what we want and basically give us the 8th number in a series of numbers. Now, let's do a quick test to see if this is working. I'm going to take those numbers, copy them, paste them over here, and drag the fill handle. Excel will do the same straight line regression, and we get 21.15, so it is actually working. Now, here's a question for you if you're watching the podcast. This array formula is an interesting formula. There are several functions that basically return array formulas. One of them, for example, is the linest function, the straight line function. And if we go into the function arguments, someone else sent a question. They said, hey, every time that I use function arguments and the resulting formula is going to be an array formula, there's no way that it'll ever work. So let's try it out. Here we have our known y's. And actually, everything else in the function is completely optional. And you see that it has two answers, 2.86 and minus 1.7. That's the slope and the y-intercept. But if we hit OK here, it's going to give us just the first answer of the position. Do you know, anyway, that using the function arguments that we can tell Excel that this is an array and we want to return all the items from the formula? I tried several things. Control-Shift-Enter won't work with the function arguments. There doesn't seem to be any good way to get function arguments to return an array formula. If you know a way, please drop me a note, bill@mrexcel.com, and we'll get to that on a future podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.